Hey, good morning, YouTube. So this is the Series 1 Pro web interface. So this is how you control the printer. And you can see I set the bed temperature to 100 C when I was up by the printer. And I did that off the tablet. And you can see it's now been hot for about 15 minutes. And I did put the front cover on. So I'm going to be printing in ABS, so I like to preheat the print head or extruder to the 240 C that I normally print at. And I just find it's a little more repeatable if I give the printer a minute or two to get up to temperature. That way all of this aluminum here can get hot. So I give the bed roughly 10 minutes to heat up, and that heats up the build chamber with the front enclosure on, and then I let the print head come up to temperature, and I'll usually give it about a minute to warm up there. So what I'll do is I'll cut back after it's been at temperature for a minute or two here. Okay, so the extruder print head's been heating up for about a minute now, and then what I'll do is come down here to Cura. So I've got the parts I want to print loaded up here in Cura, and I have my parameter set, 0.2 millimeter layer thickness. Here's the 240 printing temperature, 100 on the bed temperature, and these parts I print without any support or adhesion. There's no brim, makes cleanup a little bit easier. And then what I like to do is I just go to the send to printer, and I like to just click that first, because then down here, move that up just a bit, it says uploading, and then I like to see this, that it says successfully uploaded. So that means it got transferred to the printer, and now I'm about 2 minutes. I can just come over here and hit print, and then it'll start. So it goes back, the printer homes back to the home position, and then it comes out to the front, and that's where it prints the little strip of material just to clear out the printer nozzle and make sure everything's working right. So there it goes across there. There we go. Now it's going to come over and start printing the two parts I had loaded. And there we go, it's printing the outline, and now it'll start filling in the actual part, base of the part itself. And this is where I like to just watch the printer for maybe a minute, just make sure that that first layer seems to be sticking, and it looks like it is. They actually do make a BuildTak material in white, so I'm thinking maybe next time I might try to buy a pack of the white sheets, because it would be a little bit easier to see how that first layer is adhering, because the black on black is, I didn't think about that at the time. Although the one advantage the black has is you can kind of see these changes in the surface texture. You can see where it's shiny, and the shiny areas are where you need to hit it with the sandpaper to rough that up a little bit. So I'm not sure if the white would be as easy to see what the surface texture looks like. But you can see right there, my first layer stuck down, and I'm printing with no brim, no supports, no raft, just printing the bare parts right on the build plate. And I've got about 2 hours to wait, and those should be done. Once they finish, I just go up there and use the little spatula under the part while the build plate's still hot, and they pop right off. And then what I'll do next part is, if I'm going to print this part again, I'll just move these up a little bit so I'm not printing in the same area. So I just move to a different part of the bed, and then I'll send to the printer and start printing with the new part. So I just sent this particular part to my 3D printer, and one of the things that Cura tells you is roughly how much material that part is going to take. So it's 24 grams, and what I have over here is I keep a little spreadsheet. So I just printed 24 grams, and I keep a column for each roll of filament, And this roll number one is one that I just ran out. And if we scroll up here, okay, so here's my column. So this was roll number one was a roll of filament I just finished last week, I think. And then roll two is a new roll of filament. So these are 1 kilogram rolls. If I scroll down here, here's my totals. So this first roll, if I enter all of the Cura data, I came out with 1,070 grams that I ran out of that spool. And I think the Cura numbers are pretty accurate. And that gave me a pretty good estimate on when I should start looking at that roll to see when it was going to run out of filament. And then here's the new roll that I'm working on. I just went over 500 grams, so I still have about half that roll left. So now I'm ready to go on that. So this is going to go for a couple hours. The nice thing with these parts, I take them right off the bed and throw them in my inventory box. They're ready to ship. There's no cleanup involved. I don't have to scrape off any brim material or clean up any edges or anything. They come right off the build plate and they can go right into a package and right out to the customer, basically. That is pretty good. So there's my printing process with ABS on BuildTak. So the key is I heat the bed up down here, make sure it's hot for about 10 minutes. Then I heat up the extruder for a minute or two. Then I start my print and just check it for the first couple of minutes, make sure everything's working there. And once it is, I am done. And I just let the printer go and I go do something else. So that is the way I work with that. So if you have any questions about that workflow, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.